welcome everyone. Hey, this is my friend Vika. She studies chemistry here at ETH Zurich in Switzerland. And welcome.
Thank you.
Thank you for being my second interview subject. You can't look at my interview questions.
True.
What are you currently doing in chemistry? Chemistry is a really big branch.
Yeah, that's true. I'm doing my master's currently. And what exactly I'm doing inorganic chemistry. I'm more driven to inorganic chemistry.
So. Okay. And so someone who doesn't study chemistry, what is inorganic?
Okay. Yeah,
it's like just no carbon, right?
No, some carbon, not much of it.
Wait, there is carbon?
Some of it.
Oh.
But mostly it's energy applications. Solar cells and everything which is shiny and which is like click words like nano or something like that. So all the cool stuff.
So organic chemistry is for losers.
No, I'm not saying that. It's just I don't like it.
Okay.
If you like it, it's okay. It's just okay.
Why did you decide to go into chemistry? Did you always want to be a chemist?
No. I wanted to be an astronaut when I was a kid.
I still want to be an astronaut.
I know, I do too. But anyway.
So a cosmonaut.
Yeah. But then at some point, I don't know, chemistry started in high school and I was just like, that's fun. Because it's like, it's both...
I don't find chemistry fun, sorry.
But it's both very, like, you have a lot of math in there, but it's not just math. So just math, is, like, stresses me out a bit.
Okay, so it's applied.
Exactly. I wouldn't say it's applied. It's a lot of cool abstract concepts, you know.
Right.
It's like, the chemistry and the is so complex that it's just cool, I guess. And I took part in students' competitions, like Chemistry Olympiads, I don't know. You heard of that?
Chemistry Olympics?
Yeah, it's called Chemistry Student Olympiads or something like that. Like, nope. There is an international chemistry Olympiad, and yeah, it's like trained us hard. It's like a sport, actually.
So did you have to run every morning and get up
no,
at 6:30?
No, I had to get up at 6:30 and then like solve chemistry problem.
That's almost like being in the Olympics.
That's true. That's true. Even maybe harder, I don't know. It's mentally
okay.
Hard, actually. It was mentally very challenging. I failed the practical part.
Oh, that's okay. Maybe you can make
that's
it
that's why I became experimental chemist.
Specifically, what is your project on?
Yeah, I'm specifically doing solar applications and energy applications of the stuff called perovskites. That's like... That's
is that
not
like
the if you
peroxide?
If you're into... No. If you know this word perovskites, it's not the oxygen perovskite. It's just a little... disclaimer. Maybe you can put a disclaimer here that this is not the perovskites that you think, but this is just if you're
I'll
into
put that
it
in.
If you're into it, you kind of know what it is. It's basically like you can make a quantum dot out of perovskites.
What can I do with a quantum dot?
You can put them in a LED TV. There are actually quantum dots TVs now. Samsung just manufacturers.
This
them.
Is not
you
an
can buy
ad.
Them. Yeah. Also, LG has. To be fair, they're much much cooler than the organic quantum dots or organic dyes. I'm sorry.
Maybe I should make a video that's like organic versus inorganic chemist.
Yeah. Probably.
And it could be an Olympics.
You can pretty much do anything. You can do a detector.
So
one
if you
of my projects
really
was...
want to make a detector,
yeah,
in your
just
future,
ask me.
Make sure you go into. Inorganic chemistry.
Yes, because organic chemists only do the drugs.
Do you have any advice for anyone, any girls, any boys, anyone that wants to pursue inorganic chemistry?
Okay, so main advice is don't be put off by the complexity. For example, here in EH, they have quantum chemistry.
Okay.
In the first semester of the first year, and a lot of students actually don't pass this course.
Okay.
That's pretty sad, but don't be put off. It's like it's very complex, but it's very interesting. There are so many different aspects of chemistry that you can do that just don't be put off by one unsuccessful project or one unsuccessful course.
And if you could tell your younger self something when you first started chemistry, what would it be?
It would be don't fail the practical part of the...
of the Olympics?
Yeah, whatever. Don't be so stressed. But things, they will come naturally. It's just, I was a lot preoccupied with stuff like what I want to do in future. Maybe don't plan too much. Like, have a plan, have a rough plan, and that's don't regret. That's very important. So if you do something and you
don't
think,
regret,
like,
that you didn't do organic chemistry.
No.
So thank you everyone for listening to this interview. If you have any more questions, anything I didn't touch on that you have for Vika, please leave them in the comments below.
Because I'm a chemist, you know.
She's a...
Can have pretty much, but not about chemistry homework, please. If you have questions about chemistry homework,
Google.
Yeah, Google it.
Please subscribe if you'd like to hear more from awesome women in STEM. And like this video if you liked it.
Also, like it anyway. You don't have any reason to not like it. It's awesome.
If you want to hear more from Vika, please click the link below to see the rest of her interview.
Or the bloopers.
Or...
Should we shut the bloopers now?
I will also put in the bloopers.
Thank you.
Okay. Awesome job.
Oh, yeah, thank you.